described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Learning Seed Company presents Reading Blue Jeans, Clothing and Culture.
This is how you dress today. Casual, comfortable, modern. Blue jeans everywhere. You don't dress like people from the past.
Now these people are dressed in period costumes.
Two women wear long dresses and straw hats with wide brims.
A period in history, usually a long time ago. These costumes recreate dress from the 18th century. Sometimes we dress to honor or recreate the past, or just to have fun. Recreating old fashions is sort of a substitute for time travel. We also wear period costumes for special occasions. Traditional bridal gowns are based on designs upper-class women wore hundreds of years ago. And grooms wear tuxedos, a traditional garment from past generations. But we don't recreate past fashions for everyday wear. Blue jeans will do just fine. Certainly, jeans are not historical costumes or period clothing, are they? In some ways, the answer is yes. Blue jeans have a story to tell about your past, if you know how to listen.
Title: Rivets and Buttonflies.
You can see part of the story in design details, the copper rivets and metal buttons, for example. They take us back to the invention of denim jeans, to San Francisco in the mid-1800s. San Francisco was a small but thriving frontier seaport in 1848, a harbor town all about shipping and commerce, until someone discovered gold nearby. Men seeking a quick fortune flooded the town around 1849. These original San Francisco 49ers rushed to the hills of California to pan for gold. A German immigrant named Levi Strauss came to San Francisco during the excitement, not to pan for gold, but to open a West Coast branch of his brother's New York wholesale dry goods business, selling clothing, blankets, tin plates, cups, needles, fabric, and household items. Levi sold white cotton fabric to Jacob Davis, a tailor in Reno, Nevada. Davis used the fabric to make work pants for laborers, surveyors, teamsters, and woodcutters. But the men found the pants didn't hold up to the rigors of long days of hard labor. Davis decided to strengthen the pocket corners using metal rivets. The pants were a hit in Reno, and other tailors were starting to imitate his design, so Davis decided to apply for a patent. But he didn't have the $68 filing fee. Davis wrote to Levi Strauss suggesting they hold the patent together. Strauss saw the potential and agreed.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.